Hey guys, it's Maymay and it's time to start our planner project. Now, several of you wanted to see the composition book, but probably about the same amount wanted to see the binder. If you don't know, I ask on Facebook which one you'd rather see, and I kind of got a split decision, but I feel like the composition was a little bit more. And I would have started with the binder today, but there's a couple of things I don't have that I still am trying to get to be able to make the binder one work, so I got to wait till those get here, and so that's one reason we're going to start with the composition book. But I'm going to do this a little bit different. One thing is I'm going to show you how to make some pockets using the paper, because I've done that before in another composition book. And the other thing is I have decided that this book is going to be for half a year. So I'm going to do 6 months in this book because it's not a whole lot of paper in here. And the way I'm going to design it, I think I'll need more. So since these are kind of thin and they're also cheap, I mean, if you can get half a year for a dollar and the other year for, you know, another dollar, because I buy these for a dollar typically. So there'll be 6 months in this book, and then the paper we're going to use is this typecraft paper. Now, if you saw my art journal on Sunday, or actually Saturday night, you will have seen this already. I got this at Michael's. It was a hot buy. It was $5. It's by Craftsmith, and it's called Typecraft. If I can find this online, I'll put a link to it. I love this paper so much. It's very me, I think. Now, and oddly enough, it's kind of pinks and I don't know, pinks and mints and things like that. But what I think makes it me is the craft and the black. Like, I love these, and I love this. And I think, you know, I love that. I just think I can really enjoy this for a long time. And that's kind of what you want to think about when you're making one of these planners. Even if you're going to do like me and only do 6 months of it, you still want to make sure it's paper you're going to enjoy. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about covering the front. And I've had so many people ask me if once I cover this with paper, if I could seal it with Mod Podge, if that would work. So I thought what I'd do is do that one on this one, and we'll just see how that turns out together. My concern is that the cardboard may buckle, but we'll see. So that's what we're going to do today is the covers, and then I'm probably, if we have enough time in this video, going to go ahead and do my separations and put my dividers in. So let's get started. First things first is pick that cover paper, and I'm always on the fence about it, but I gotta tell you, you know I love stripes right now, and I think we may be getting bored with my love of stripes, but I do love them so much. I'm probably gonna lean to that stripe paper pretty heavily. I like those too. Oh, wait a minute, I could do this. I do not hate this paper, so we can use that on the front. And you know me, I like to use my least favorite paper on the back. That's a little busy for me, even though it is not my favorite. That would probably be one of my least favorite, because I'm not a big fan of the mint color. I know, forgive me. Let's see. I think I'm going to use this on the back, because I'm not real big into the word pages, but it would look good on the back of the planner. So there we go, and that looks good together. So let's get started covering them. What I need to do here is measure the front. And I'm going to leave this black exposed, so I'm going to measure this. So it is 6¾ by 9¾. So I'm going to cut that real quick with my paper cutter. I want to show you something that I'm doing, and it may seem like overkill, and that's okay if you don't want to do this. I like a half inch rounded corner. It's just me. I just like it a little stronger than what you get on these books. And they're typically the quarter inch. Like if you have this little memory chomper or this little crocodile, you have a half inch and a quarter inch. If you use the quarter inch rounder, you're fine. But I really love the look of a half inch. Isn't that silly to be so picky? But I like it. So what I did was on this top part, I went through and corner rounded every single page. So I've already done the front cover here. I'm going to do the bottom so you can see me do it. All I do is take this paper and stick it in here like this. Oops. And punch it. That's all there is to it. And I do that all the way through. And it'll hold a pretty good, it'll punch a pretty good bit at one time. So it's not as bad as it seems. Like, why are you doing this? I just like the half inch better than the quarter. It's just me. But you could so do this with a quarter. And like I said, this is overkill. This is not something you have to do. And then I'm going to do the back cover the same. So then, we flip it over, I have all of them at that bigger round. I don't know why I do that. I just like it that way. And I don't always do it. It's just sometimes I like it. And on this book, that's how I wanted it. Now, don't worry about where we're still seeing a little bit of that composition book behind it, because we're going to be putting things to cover stuff up, especially here. It's very hard to cut these exact for these binders. So we're going to adhere this down. Now, I'm going to do that with sticky tape because, and I've said this before, with sticky tape, I can get adhesive all the way to the edge. Now, I'm interested to see how this is going to do with the Mod Podge. We're going to learn it together. But when I use my sticky tape, I know that this paper is stuck down nice and firm all the way to the edge. And if you've never used this tape, this is good stuff. I will put a link to the tape below. So you guys can pick some up. This stuff is awesome. And I typically do one good diagonal piece in the middle, and then I use some wet glue. So that way I'm not using all of that. Now, if you have the full sheets of the sticky tape, Jamie at Punch Place Plus has the full sheets, and I'll put a link to that too. They are awesome, and you can do those full sheets, which I've used in the past, and they make things super easy. I'm out of them right now, which is sad because I love them. So I got that released, and then just use your favorite wet glue. My favorite right now is this art glitter glue. I think it dries fast and quick, and it is amazing. I'll put a link to it also. And I just like to put it in the spots where I don't have sticky tape. All right, now when you're putting this down, pay attention to these edges, lining this edge up right, your outside edge, because like I said, you're going to be putting embellishments on the other side. So as long as the outside and top and bottom edges are good, if this doesn't quite match up like mine does, it doesn't matter. We're going to fix that anyway. This is awesome. Love it. Now I'm going to do the same to the back side. You don't have to watch me do all that. I'm just going to do it and we'll get right back together. So there we go. I got the top and the bottom done. Now I want to see what decorations I want to put on the front. So I'm going to go back to the paper pad. And you may have some other things in your craft room, you know, some embellishments or things. I want to keep this kind of flat. I love this. Today is a pretty good day. Dream. Like, I love that whole thing together. This whole piece. And this says, Be Always Blooming. I really like this. I think I'm going to use this. I'm going to take this out here. I have another idea for this, too. While I'm cutting this, I want to talk to you about this. I don't like a lot of clutter on the front of my albums. Now, I know that's not true shabby chic style, but I don't really do shabby chic very well. So what you'll see me do is simple and to the point, because I'm not good at that. I don't have an eye for that, in my opinion. I'm better at crisp and clean. So that's why something like this is perfect. I love that. And then I love this chevron piece. I'm going to see if I can incorporate it as well, because I really like that stripe of chevron. Isn't that cute like that? I love that. Now, I also, whenever I'm doing busy patterns with something like this, if I just put this on here, it's going to get lost. So I want to mat this with some black so it'll pop off the page. So this is how I typically do it. I go ahead and put my adhesive on here. I'm not going to use my big one this time because I'm kind of running out. Getting low on that big one. I'll have to order some more. And then, I just take this piece and decide how big of a mat I want in two corners. I'm working in these top two corners, okay? I kind of want it to be kind of chubby because I really want it to show very well. And I just sort of line that up in those two corners, nice and straight. Like so. And then I bring my paper trimmer to it and just kind of match that up. That's my lazy way of doing it. This way I don't have to measure anything. And if it's not perfect, I'm not going to stress about it. I'm not a stressor about things that are not perfect. Have y'all noticed that yet? You have to, because I do so many things upside down. I think I got this side a little bit. Look, I just said I'm not going to stress about it, but I think that's a tiny bit bigger right there. Look at that little tiny bit. But don't stress about it. So there is that piece. I love that piece. So that'll go on the front. And also this piece. I'm going to basically turn this into kind of like some washi tape. I'm going to take this wide adhesive. Look, it's perfect fit. Perfect fit. I'm going to run this down. This strip of paper. Love that. So the more I look at it, the more I like the idea of just this craft paper, the craft color. So I'm going to adhere that down. I'm just going to use wet glue this time. And I'm just going to do kind of the same thing. And this one, I think I'm going to let this border be a little thinner. And trim it the same way. Yep, I really like that. The other thing I think, and I'm going to do this before I adhere it onto the book, is I think this needs a little white. Like from like a white gel pen. So I'm going to take my white pen and see if I can't make these words pop a little bit more just by maybe adding a stripe to the edges. Something like this. Might even outline them all the way around. That just really makes this word today pop. Just kind of was dropping back into the background a little more than I wanted it to. You could do dash lines around it. You could do polka dots. You don't have to just draw. Circles are my hard part. I always end up going oval. So I tend to do part and then come back around. I still went oval with that one. Even following a line, I tend to do this oval thing. I don't know, maybe it's my depth perception. That was better. I just think that makes that pop so much more. And then I'm going to do it inside of these letters. And the reason is you can't see them very well, but they're very cute. Today is a pretty great day. Now, I don't know what the Mod Podge is going to do this, but we'll learn it together. I think it should be fine. Just pops so much more, doesn't it? Now I think I'll do maybe some stitch lines in the dream. See how much more that pops? Just a little bit of color. And then I'm going to do some here too. Just to add a little white. Just so it drags all the way down the page. Keeps your eye moving. Okay. And then, of course, I'm going to need some stitch lines on this black. Don't you agree? So there it is. That's the piece I'll be putting on the front. And this is where you can get dimension on your project without actually adding dimension. Because, like I said, I like to keep this front page very flat. See how much more that's going to pop now just by having the white stitches and the white details? I think it'll really pop better that way. All right, so let's adhere this down. And I'm going to use some white wet glue. All right, and now to decide if I want it straight or tilted. I think I'm going to do straight because I'm going to be adding that chevron strip to the side. And I'm actually even going a little off-centered because this strip is going to take up some space. So I want to kind of see where I want this to go. You don't have much time with that art glitter glue. You got to get it there quick. Because it is going to lock it in place for you. I love how that looks. All right, let's add our strip that we created. And I want it to go kind of half on and half off, but as far out as I can take it. So I'm thinking something like this. Let me look at it straight on. Yep. I'll seal that down. And then I'm just going to flip it over and cut it away. But I tell you what, I'm going to use my X-Acto blade because it'll be easier and I'll get a much nicer even cut that way. So there is that. I think that looks nice. I like it. I got a little bit of adhesive sticking out here. I'm going to rub that away if I can. This adhesive is not the easiest to rub away. Sometimes you have to work with it to get it gone because it is really strong adhesive. But you can get it if you just kind of rub at it. And don't go too crazy because you're going to put some Mod Podge over it so nothing's going to catch on it. Alright, so see there, look how quick that is, and now we have this. Now, if you stopped right here, you have a great journal. You have a back cover, you have the front covered, and this is an awesome journal for you. So you could stop here. Of course, we're not. We're going to go ahead and cover the insides as well. And I know I want to use this stripe paper. This is one I used from my art journal page. I'm going to use it on the inside here because I love it. And I'm going to pick another one for the back. I kind of like that. It's not quite as bold. I really like this. Let's put this in the back. Now, I know I've told you guys this before, but anytime I'm working with a specific paper pack, I have one spot where I take these pieces and put them, and I always put them either in a basket or a box or a bag right beside me, and that way, when I need to get to some scraps for something, I'll have them. All right, so the next thing we want to do is round these corners for the front side here, and remember, you're going to have one going here and one going here, so you want to kind of dry fit them before you do the rounding of the corners. Or you could round the wrong corners. So I know I'm rounding this one and this one for this side. Okay. And then, I'm glad I did that because I like those circles going upwards. So this side and this side. Notice I'm not adding the wet glue this time. I don't feel like on these parts they're going to get as much stress as the covers will. I'm not as worried about those right now. I'm just going to stick these down. Now notice I have that little edge showing there and I also have an edge showing here. These things are cut so irregular. I'm not going to worry about that right now. We can always come back and fix that later. I'm also not going to be Mod Podging the inside. I feel like they'll be perfectly protected. It's paper inside of paper. It'll be fine. But I am going to Mod Podge the front and the back. And I tell you what I'm going to do. Before I do too much more work on the inside, I'm going to go ahead and Mod Podge the front and the back cover so that way, if it doesn't work, I don't spend too much time in here and we get to see how it's going to react. So I'm going to go ahead and get my Mod Podge and get this front cover done. So I have my gloss finish Mod Podge, which I don't use very often, but I thought it might be fun to do something a little different this time and gloss it up. That'll kind of make it look very store-bought, I think. So I'm just gonna dip into the Mod Podge and start painting. I am excited about seeing how this is gonna seal everything in place. I'm being careful to come straight off the page so as not to glue anything down. But if you're very concerned about that, just do this. I use wax paper underneath mine. So just take your wax paper and kind of fold it up like this. And that way you know it won't seal shut. So many of you asked me about this last time. And it's, you know, if this works, I think it's a great way to do your recipe books too. Because they are going to be in the kitchen. I'll link the video from our recipe book as well. And if you haven't seen, we have a giveaway for two packs of those papers. The Homemade with Love from Cartabella, Miss Judy Garner, is sponsoring a giveaway for you guys. So I'll link that video as well. So if you haven't seen that, that way you can get in and take a chance at winning those paper packs. She's giving away two of them to two of my lucky subscribers. I'm the lucky one to have subscribers that are willing to do stuff like that. That's just how, she just contacted me and said, I've got 2 packs of that paper. I'd love to do a giveaway. And I was just like, that would be incredible. So that's what she's doing. She's even going to send it to you, to the lucky winners. Now, one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do multiple thin coats. I'm at least going to do 2 coats, but I'm trying to do them pretty thin because I don't want to take a chance of the cardboard buckling. So I'm just making sure I got everything covered good. And then I'm going to quit and let it dry and come back and do another coat. So I don't know if you can see this on camera, but after 1 coat, I got a little bit of buckling. Let me pull this off. A little bit of buckling in this paper. And if you remember, this is the paper I didn't put any wet adhesive down on. I just used the sticky tape to hold it down. And I'm only getting the buckling where the tape isn't. So I think as long as you adhere everything down nice and tight with maybe a good wet adhesive on those pieces, you'll be fine. Now I'm going to go ahead and do that second coat. Not sure it needs it, but I'm going to do it because I think it'll be just a little extra protection because I did go very thin on that first coat. And I'm going to do the same on this one, nice and thin. But I do think if you went ahead and used some liquid adhesive, on that one piece, I didn't use the extra liquid, and I should have. I think that's what got me there. And if you don't like the paintbrush, you know, marks, try to go in the same direction with your Mod Podge. I'm not a big fan of them, so I try to keep them going in the same direction. And that way it doesn't look like a painting as much as it looks like just a coating. I also got a little bit of buckling here. I'm not sure why. Maybe my adhesive wasn't very good. Wasn't stuck down perfectly, but I got a little buckle on that. But the cover itself has not buckled. And that's what I was really worried about, is that it would kind of curl. And sometimes I found when things sit overnight with Mod Podge, they settle back down. So it could be the buckling from the fact that the paper has gotten wet from the Mod Podge. And once it cures, it could sit. We'll find out. All right, so I'm going to let this coat dry. And then I'm going to call that it on the coats of Mod Podge. Just 2 coats. Shouldn't need more than that, I wouldn't think. And then I'm going to go ahead and do the back side. And then when we get together the next time, we'll be working on the inside of the book. And you'll get to see how it turned out with the curing and everything. So thanks so much, guys, for being with me today. This is going to be a fun one. I'm not sure how many videos it'll take to finish this one. A couple, I'm sure. But so for today, we got our covers done and did a little test with the Mod Podge. And we'll see how that turns out when it's all dried and cured. Talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.